Good evening and welcome to Coal City Theater Department's production of The Outsiders. At this time, we ask that everyone please turn off all cell phones or electronic devices as the frequencies interfere with our microphone systems. There is to be no photography or videography of this performance, as it is prohibited by law. Please be advised that this production contains fog, haze, strobe lights, gunshots, and pyrotechnics. Restrooms are located inside the school. Just a reminder that when leaving your socially distant viewing space, masks are required. We are thrilled to be safely back, and we hope you enjoy The Outsiders.
Mr. Sime?
Hi.
This is Pony Poi. I'm sorry it's so late. I forgot. I'm calling about the theme assignment for English. How long can it be? Not less than 5 pages, right? But it can be longer. Longer than 5 pages? As long as I want. It's all in my head. I just have to sort it out. First, I have to sort it out. As soon as I can get it together. No later than that. Thanks, Mr. Sun. The place to begin. I'd gone to a movie. When I stepped into the bright sunlight from the darkness of that movie house, I had only two things on my mind. Paul Newman and a ride home. I wish I looked like Paul Newman. He looks tough. Yeah, and I don't. The other thing, it's a long walk home with no company, but I usually loan it. I like to watch the movies undisturbed so I can live them, you know, get into them with the actors. I'm different like that. I mean, my second oldest brother, Soda Pop, he never cracks a book at all. My oldest brother, Derry, works way too hard to ever get into a story or a picture. You know, so I'm different than them. And nobody in our gang digs books and movies the way I do. So I loan it. Greaser! And I'm a greaser. Greasers can't walk alone too much, or they get jumped by the socias. I'm not really sure how you spell that, but it's the abbreviation for the socials. The jet set. You know, the rich kids. Yeah, greasers are poorer than the socias. But I reckon we're wilder, too. Because unlike socias who wreck houses, jump greasers, and throw beer blasts, greasers are like hoods. Yeah, we steal things. You know, drive old souped-up cars. Get in gang fights. Well, I don't mean I do. I mean, Derry would kill me if I ever got in trouble with the police. Ever since Mom and Dad died in a car wreck, they let the three of us stay together, but only as long as we stay together and behave. Yeah. So, Soda Pop and I try staying out of trouble as much as we can. I'm not saying that either the greases or the socias are better. It's just the way things are.
Hey, Grease! How come you're all by yourself, Grease?
Hey, stay away from me!
Couldn't think of it. It's not safe for you to be out here all alone.
We're gonna do you a favor, Grease.
We're gonna shave that greasy hair of yours.
Leave me alone, okay?
Need a haircut, Grease?
Oh, no.
Gonna cut her real close.
How'd you like your haircut to begin?
Just below the chin.
What are you, crazy? Soda! Derry!
Shut him up.
Hey, Bob, I think I see someone.
Derry.
Okay, Grease.
Yeah, said cool it, Bob.
Well, he's asking for it.
No, company's coming.
Have to give you another appointment, Grease. Catch you later.
Tony boy, you okay?
They cut you?
No talk. It was nothing. They're cruising our territory.
So scum.
Let's get them!
You're really okay? You're not hurt?
Yeah, just a little spooked. That's all. I mean, compared to what they did to you, it's nothing. Nothing at all.
They have to stop jumping us, Pony. They have to stop.
Hey, what's in your hand?
It's nothing. Never mind, Pony Boy.
Johnny.
I can't take another beating. I can't take it. I get enough from my father.
You alright?
Tony!
I'm okay, Derry, I'm okay.
They didn't cut him, Derry. Sorry.
You're never sorry. No, not about anything.
Hey, the kid's okay. You're an okay kid, Pony.
Did you guys catch him?
No. They got away.
I hit their car with a couple rocks. I don't think they like that.
I didn't know you were out of jail, Dallas.
Got off early. Good behavior.
Pony boy, what were you doing walking by your lonesome?
I was coming home from the movies.
I didn't think that the
you
socials...
You don't ever think. Not at home or anywhere when it counts. You must think at school with all those good grades, you've always got your nose in a book. But do you ever think to use your head for common sense? If you're going to go out by yourself, you should have carried a blade.
No matter what I did, you wouldn't like it.
Hey, leave my kid brother alone here. It ain't his fault he likes to go to the movies. It ain't his fault the socials like to jump us too. And if he would have been carrying a blade, that would have been a great excuse to cut him to ribbons.
When I want my kid brother to tell me what to do with my other kid brother, I'll ask him. Kid brother.
Next time, get one of us to go with you, Pony Boy. Any of us will.
Speaking of movies, I'm heading over to the Nightly Double tomorrow night. Anybody want to come with and hunt some action?
No time. I'm working.
You're always working.
I've got a choice.
Soda pop?
So I'm picking up Sandy for the game.
Oh, my God.
Huh? Come on.
No.
Jesus. I'm glad to hear you say that.
But Sandy, can you stay?
No.
He's at home. You have to go?
I've got a choice.
Pony Boy, Johnny, you guys want to come?
Yeah, me and Johnny will come. Okay, Derry?
It ain't a school night.
Since it ain't a school night.
If I don't get boozed up, I'll walk over and find y'all.
If I ever catch you getting boozed up.
Hey, whoa, Derry!
Hey, who needs boozed up?
I've seen you lots of times.
Whoa, when?
Tubit's right. Soda gets drunk lots of times.
Where have I been?
Drag races? At a dance? Only, he never touches alcohol.
Come on, Sandy.
You don't need alcohol.
What is she talking about?
He gets drunk on just plain living.
Yeah, probably I'll find y'all.
Hey, Tubit, if you're headed toward my place, if you're walking in that direction...
Happens, I'll be going right by your place, Johnny Cake. Right by your door.
Thanks.
Remember how Johnny looked when he got beat up? I mean, why did the socials hate us so much?
We're greasers. That's just how it works.
I'm reading this book in English. Great Expectations. And that kid, Pip, he reminds me a lot of us. The way he felt marked lousy because he wasn't a gentleman or anything. The way that girl looked down on him.
That's only a book, Pony.
Yeah.
It happened to me. In biology, we were dissecting worms and my razor wouldn't cut. So I used my switchblade.
Tony!
I forgot what I was doing. Otherwise, I never would have done it. The minute I flicked it out, the girl sitting next to me sort of gasped. And said, "They are right. You are a hood.
Soch, Was she pretty?
She looked real good in yellow. Hey, but don't tell Derry, okay? He'll say I didn't think again.
He probably would have, but when he hollers at you, he doesn't mean nothing.
Yeah, like hell.
Have to get home before my mother gets hacked off. I wouldn't want to miss the game tomorrow.
Wouldn't miss it for anything. If you give it all?
Better meet me. I'll be at the dingo.
She's different.
From what?
From the only girls that'll look at greasers. Tough, loud girls. Wear too much eye makeup and swear too much. I like Sandy.
She doesn't have it easy. She's got school and work.
And a whole lot of trouble at home. Hey, Soda.
Yeah.
How come you dropped out of school? I mean, I could hardly stand it when you left.
I mean, because I'm dumb. I mean, the only thing I was passing was auto mechanics and gym.
You ain't dumb.
Shut up. I am. Yeah, let me tell you something, but don't tell Derry.
Okay.
I think I'm going to marry Sandy. I mean, when I get a better job and she gets out of school and everything. But I might wait till you get out too, so I can help Derry with the bills.
Yeah, tough enough. Wait till I get out. So you keep Derry off my back.
Hey, don't be like that. I told you he don't mean half of what he says. He just got more worrisome at his age as Otta. He cares about you, because you're brainy.
Yeah, sure.
Hey, maybe we deserve a lot of what we get. Dallas, he deserves everything and should get more if you want the truth. And Tubin, he don't need or want half the things he swipes from stores. It's not like that with Derry. He don't deserve to work like an old man at the age of 20. I mean, even with the athletic scholarships, there wasn't money for college. Derry doesn't do anything, and he doesn't go anywhere. All he does is work. But he's got hopes for you, you dig?
Then why does he bug me all the time?
I mean, you're the baby. He loves ya.
You're wrong. Okay? He just sees me as another mouth to feed. That's all I mean to him.
You should get out and do schoolwork.
You in love with Sandy?
Yeah.
What's it like?
Real nice. What's that book you're reading for English?
Great Expectations?
Great Expectations.
Folks, and a hearty welcome to our drive-in theater. We have a wonderful evening's entertainment lined up for you. One that will provide several hours of pleasurable relaxation and diversion for you and your family. Don't forget to visit our refreshment center during the intermission or any time. You'll love the tasty array of snacks we have to offer. So will the youngsters. Everything is quality and so good. Oh, a word of caution. Don't drive over 10 miles an hour in the theater area for your safety's sake. And Mom or Pop, go with the kids when they leave the car. We hope you have a wonderful time. Come back soon.
We were a little early for the movie. So we were talking to all the greasers we knew. Leaning in on car windows or hopping into back seats. Getting in on who's running away or who was in jail or who was going with who and who stole what and when and why. By then it was dark enough to sneak under the back fence of the drive-in.
Go home, both of you! Dry out!
Come on, Johnny, just slide.
Why don't...
Follow me. You know how he hates to do things legal.
Hey, move it, pony boy.
Sure, Dallas.
You really made them mad. Don't you object? Bob and Randy are disgusting. I don't want to sit with them either. Look, they need a lesson. We came to see a movie. We'll see a movie. Bikinis on Muscle Beach.
It must be something by J.D. Salinger.
Really?
Marcia.
Is this hair real or a wig?
Stop that.
I guess it's real. Want to check if I'm real?
Tell us.
Watch the picture.
Bikinis on Muscle Beach. Like to see some real muscle?
How about you find your seat and shut up?
Who's gonna make me?
That's the greaser that jockeys for the Slash J sometimes.
I know you two. I've seen you around the rodeos.
Well, it's a shame you can't ride, but half as good as you talk it.
You two barrel race, huh?
And you'd better leave us alone. Or I'll call the cops.
Oh no! Oh no! Did you hear what she said?
You're screaming at them. You should check my record sometime. Guess what I've been in for.
Please leave us alone. Why don't you be nice and leave us alone?
I'm never nice. Want a Coke?
I wouldn't drink it if I was starving in the desert. Get lost, Hood! Oh, what, are you gonna start on us too?
No.
You don't look the type. What's your name?
I wish you hadn't asked. It's Ponyboy Curtis.
Oh, that's an original and lovely name.
My dad was an original person. I have a brother named Soda Pop. And it says so on his birth certificate!
My name's Sherry, but I'm called Cherry because of my hair. Cherry Bounce.
I know. You're a cheerleader. We go to the same school.
You don't look old enough for high school.
I'm not. I got put up here in grade school.
What's a nice, smart kid like you running around with trash like that for?
I'm a grease. Same as Talus, he's my buddy.
I'm sorry, Pony Boy. Oh, hey, your brother! Does he work at a gasoline station, DX?
Yeah.
Man, your brother is one doll? I could have guessed you're related. You look alike. Why are you blushing?
It's not every day that we hear a good-looking soap say something like that.
How come we never see him around school?
He's a dropout.
Johnny cake.
Thanks.
For you. Pony boy.
Thank God.
And for the redhead who likes muscles. Maybe it'll cool you off.
This might cool you off, greaser. After you wash your mouth out and learn to talk and act decent, I might cool off too.
Fiery, huh? That's the way I like them.
Leave her alone, Dallas!
Uh-huh. What'd you say, Johnny King?
You heard me. I said leave her alone.
What? Hey, you want to repeat that?
Leave her alone.
Thanks. He had me scared.
You sure didn't show it. Nobody talks to Dallas like you did.
From what I saw, you do.
Hey, one time a guy told Dallas to move over at a candy counter, and Dallas belted him so hard he knocked a tooth loose.
You got a lot of guts, Johnny. Will you cool it, Pony Boy?
You guys can sit with us. You can protect us.
Okay. Yeah, might as well.
So, how old are you?
14? 16?
That's funny. I thought you were both
16!
How come you guys aren't scared of us like you were Dallas?
Well, first you didn't join in on the way he was talking, and then you made him leave us alone. And when we asked you guys to sit up here, you didn't act like it was an invitation to make out for the night.
Oh.
Look, I've heard about Dallas Winston, and he looks mean, but Not you two.
Well, yeah, sure. We're young and innocent.
No, not innocent. You guys have seen too much to be innocent. Just not dirty.
Dallas is okay. I mean, yeah, he's tough, but he's a cool old guy.
Yeah, he'd leave you alone if he knew you.
Well, I'm glad he doesn't know us.
You know, it's funny. In a way, I kind of admire him.
Hey, weren't you guys yelling at someone a while ago?
Our dates. They brought along some booze.
I don't want to sit in a drive-in and watch someone get drunk.
But you really made them mad.
I don't care.
Okay, greasers, you've had it. Glory Two-Bit, it's just me. I can see that. Could have given us some heart attacks. Hey, Johnny. Kid, Johnny, come on.
Hey, Two-Bit. Sorry, kid. I forgot.
Who is this, your great aunt?
Great grandmother's twice removed.
Sharp one? How could you two be picked up by a couple of greasy hoods like Johnny and Pony? Cut it out, Two-Bit.
Dally was bothering them. When he left, they asked us to suit them.
To protect them from greasers like you. Where is old Dallas? Tim Shepard's looking for him.
Dallas is hunting some action.
He'll probably find a fight. He slashed Tim's tires just for kicks. Which is no joke when you have to work to pay for them. So they have a fight.
Well, you don't believe in rough playing or anything.
Well, Tim's okay. A fair fight ain't rough. Blades are rough. So are chains, heaters, and pool sticks. Skin fight ain't rough, though. It's just, Dallas got caught. He pays up. It's no sweat.
Oh, yeah, boy, real simple.
Gets killed or something, just bury him. No sweat.
He did okay, baby.
Pony boy, will you come with me? Go get some popcorn?
Sure. Hey. Y'all want some?
Y'all watch the movie.
Oh,
come on.
Watch this. I don't think I got your numbers.
What numbers?
Street address, telephone. Hey, the girl said you should watch the movie. So watch the movie.
Maybe I can find a piece of paper somewhere.
Cherry didn't really want popcorn. She wanted to talk.
Your friend, the blonde one. He's okay?
I mean, he ain't dangerous like Dallas, if that's what you mean. He's okay.
Johnny's been hurt bad sometime, hasn't he? He looks hurt and scared.
It's worse than that. It was the socias.
I don't want to wash bikinis on Muscle Beach. I want to know about this.
Soda and I were kicking rocks down the street, and then we noticed Johnny's jacket on the ground. And there was a hump across the lot. And then there was a moan. Soda got there first and turned him over. I nearly puked. We're used to seeing Johnny all banged up. I mean, his father clobbers him a lot. But nothing like this. Soda was there on his knees, holding him, his body all limp. Kept giving him little shakes, saying, it's okay, Johnny. No, they're gone now, it's okay. Two-Bit was suddenly there, and for once, he had nothing smart to say. Dallas got there too, swearing under his breath. Then he turned away and got sick. Dallas, sick! Finally, Johnny figured it was Soda that was holding him. Started shaking and crying.
help, so. Said there was a whole bunch of them. A blue Buick full. Sort of just kept telling them, don't talk, and over, and over, and over. They've gone, that Johnny Cake.
A blue Buick?
Johnny tried to run, but they caught him.
One of them had rings on his hand. It's what cut Johnny so bad.
Not all sources are like that, Pony Boy. You have to believe me. Not all of us are like that.
Yeah, sure.
Well, that's like saying all greasers are like Dallas Winston. I bet he's shocked a few people.
Well, lots of times, but that
but
doesn't mean...
But you think
that...
the sources have it made, don't you?
Well, you do!
It may come as a surprise, but we've got troubles you've never even heard of. You want to know something? Things are tough all over!
Then why are we so different?
You're more emotional. You're sophisticated, cool to the point of not feeling anything. I catch myself talking and realize I don't mean half of what I'm saying. I don't really think a beer blast at the river bottom is super cool, but I mean, I'll rave about it just to be saying something. I've never told that to anyone before. You're the first person. Why is that?
Because I'm young. And because I'm a greaser, so you don't have to keep your guard up.
You for a kid, you're awful smart.
Yeah, I'll probably outgrow it. We better get some popcorn and get back to the movie.
It's 1 minute till showtime.
The picture hasn't even started. You read a lot of books, don't you, Pony Boy?
Yeah, why?
I can just tell. I bet you watch sunsets.
Well,
I did too. You know, before I got so busy.
You eat all the popcorn?
Oh, it was delicious.
Yeah.
How are we gonna get home? Maybe I should call my folks.
I'll walk you.
It's 20 miles.
It's still early? If we get started,
Johnny.
There's a car at my place.
Oh, here we go.
Take us 10 minutes to walk there. It runs real good. I could drive you. Trying to figure out what's the cool thing to do.
Cupid's car's okay?
It's a wreck. Okay. Cupid will get you home, though.
Thanks, Cupid. Let's start walking.
Well, aren't we adventurous?
Oh, well, if you'd rather call your parents...
Nah.
Maybe I should run ahead and clean out the back seat.
No, we'll walk together.
I'm sure there's enough gas.
Cherry, look what's coming.
Oh, man. That's a tough car. Buicks are tough.
What are we gonna do?
Stand here. Not much else we can do.
Well, who is it? The FBI?
It's Randy and Bob.
Great. And a few more of those socially elite. Check out your set in the back seat.
Your boyfriends?
Oh, look, maybe they didn't see us. I just act normal.
Who's acting? I'm a natural normal. I wish it was the other way around.
You mean?
What you mean?
That was close.
It's...
What?
Blue.
What is?
Johnny, tell me, why do they call you Johnny Cake?
Well, his real name is Johnny.
Hey.
They have to get home. Okay, you gotta move it, Johnny.
Johnny, what does it mean when you say tough? It's a tough car.
It just means
how... I was asking Johnny!
It means okay. Really right? Sharp? Like you and Marcia. Our two tough girls.
Do you have brothers to help with things at home?
No. Pony Boy's lucky, though. He has two.
I'm lucky to have Soda Pop. And Dairy.
Well, hold on, you don't talk about your oldest brother.
I mean, what's there to talk about? He's big and handsome. And he used to play football.
That's it?
Tell me what he's like.
He's a good guy. You're completely... He's hard as a rock, okay? And about as human. He's got eyes exactly like frozen ice. But he thinks I'm a pain in the neck, okay? He can't stand me.
Hold on.
You and Derek. It's true. I bet he wishes he could put me in a home somewhere. And he'd do it too if so didn't let him.
That ain't right, Pony Boy.
You got it all wrong. Derry really
just
cares.
Shut up, Johnny Cade.
Derry don't want me at home, and we all know you ain't wanted either.
How could you talk to Johnny like that? How could you do it? It's all right. He didn't mean.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Johnny. I was just mad because I was making a fool of myself in front of everybody. It's the truth. I'm not wanted. And I don't care.
Shut up talking like that. Without you, we couldn't get along.
Maybe I should call my folks.
It just don't seem fair.
What isn't fair?
Like Johnny's father being a mean drunk and his mother a selfish slob. Two-bits mom working at a bar to support him and his kid sister after their father ran out on them. Dallas hates the world. Even Soda Pop. A dropout so he can get a job and keep me in school. And Derry. Getting old before his time. Trying to hang on to two jobs. Trying to raise a family. Never having any fun. Well, the socialists have so much spare time and money. They gang up on each other and jump greasers just for kicks. You throw beer blasts and river bottom parties just because you don't know what else to do.
I tried explaining to you.
Sure. Things are tough all over town. All over our side.
It's the way things are. Like it? Or lump it?
Well, we've been spotted.
It's a Buick.
Cherry. Marcia. Listen to us.
Look, you guys are making a big deal out of nothing.
Just because we got a little drunk.
A little? And you call reeling and passing out in the street a little?
And now look.
And now you look. I told you I'm never going out with you while you're drinking. Too many things could happen.
Baby, you know we don't get drunk very often.
You're not hearing very good. I said never.
Jerry. Marcia. And even if you're mad at us, there's no reason to be walking around with all of these...
These what?
Vermin.
Who you calling vermin?
This is a little grease that needs a haircut.
And this is the Soch with the blue Buick. And all the rings on his hand.
Maybe you'd like a closer look.
It was you. Can you guys just cool off?
You greasers think you can get away with walking our girls. Our girls!
You're out of your territory. You better watch it.
Next time, pick your own kind. Dirt.
Hey, greasers. You know, we got four more in the back seat still.
Then pity the back seat. Are you looking for a fight?
Should we run for it? It's too late.
I asked you a question.
You mean if I'm looking for a good jumping, you outnumber us. So you'll give it to us, right? Hey, y'all!
You got it right. Okay, kid, you want a repeat performance?
You touch that kid! I call the police!
Hold it a minute.
Y'all. What?
Back off, guys.
You and Dare.
I don't want to fight.
So I'll go home with you, but first you sit in the car and you wait.
Wait?
You wait till we come over.
Hey, we ain't scared of them.
I can't stand fights. Okay, I can't stand them. Yes or no?
We'll wait 1 minute.
You think I'll let a little grease get away with walking my girl?
Bob, I said sit in the car. I'll be along in a minute.
See ya.
We better go with him, Pony Boy.
I know.
It's too dangerous. And if I see you at school and don't say hi, it's not personal. You know, it's
just the way things are.
We couldn't even let our parents see us together.
It's okay. Just remember that some of us watch sunsets too.
Hey, let's not push the 1 minute warning.
It's time. I hope I never see that Dallas Winston again.
What, because he's one of us?
Because I just might fall in love with him.
How'd that be for trouble?
Marcia's phone number.
I must have been out of my mind to ask for it.
Yeah, you were.
Probably phony anyway. I think I'll go play a little snooker or hunt up a poker game. I don't know. But man, those two girls were tough.
Yeah, but if they see us in school, they can't say hi.
If that's the worst of your problems.
They saved us from a fight, Pony. I'm really glad we didn't have to fight.
Hey, we'd have done okay.
You don't understand. I can't take it again. I'd rather kill myself or something.
Hey, you can't kill yourself, okay? Don't talk like that.
I have to do something. Maybe I'll sleep here in the park tonight. Listen to the water in the little fountain. Pretend it's a waterfall someplace in the mountains. I wish there was a place without Carissa's and Socius. A place with just people.
Maybe out in the country. When we had the whole family, we'd drive out in the country.
Let me tell you something, Pony. I think I like it better when the old man's hitting me. At least then I know he knows who I am. I walk in the house, nobody says anything. I walk out, nobody says nothing. I stay away all night, and nobody notices. At least you have soda. I don't have anyone.
Shoot, you got the whole gang!
It's not like having your own folks to care about you. It's not the same, Pony.
Johnny went to sleep first. And because I was asleep too, and dreaming, I brought Mom and Dad back to life. Mom would bake things, and Dad would get up early, drive the pickup, and go feed the cattle. Mom was golden, beautiful. When I woke up, I thought, oh, glory, what time is it? Johnny's still asleep. Just the thought of facing Derry this late made me shake. I ran home as quick as I could, and I saw, if only they're still asleep.
Pony, where the heck have you been? Do you know what time it is?
It's
2 in the morning, kiddo. Another hour, and I would have the police out after you. Where were you? Where? In the almighty universe, were you?
I went to sleep in the lot.
You what?
Pony Boy, where have you been?
I didn't mean to, okay? I was talking to Johnny, and then we both just dropped off. It never occurred to you that your brothers might be worrying their heads off and afraid to call the police because it might get you thrown into a boy's home so quickly it would make your head spin. And you're asleep in the lot. What's the matter with you?
I said I didn't mean to.
I didn't mean to. I didn't think. I forgot. That's all I hear at you. Can't you think of anything?
Derry. Derry.
You keep your smart mouth shut. I am sick and tired of hearing you stick up for him.
Don't yell at him.
Pony. Hey, I didn't mean to.
I remember my first thought. You know, I thought, I'll go find Johnny and we'll run away. I remember thinking, at least things couldn't get any worse. I was wrong.
Hey, Johnny, by the phone, watch out! Grab the one by the phone!
What's wrong?
Hey, stop giving that one a bath!
Take a drink, Greasy!
Get off me! Hungry! I'm drowned! It's time to stay down, Grease! He's drowning! Hey, hold on!
Johnny! Johnny, what happened?
I killed him. I killed him, Pony.
I think I'm gonna be sick.
I already was. This can't be happening. This can't be. You killed him? They were about to kill you, Pony. You are gonna die! They put people in the electric chair for murder! What are we gonna do? I don't know.
First thing, keep your mouth shut.
Dallas.
I heard the Sosas were cruising our neighborhoods.
They were killing Pony.
I see. The police will be here any minute. You need money and you need a plan. Do Soda and Derry know about this? I ain't itching to be the one to tell Derry.
Hey, don't tell him!
Put this on you. You'll die of pneumonia before the cops even get you. There's $50 in the pocket.
What do we do?
Take the 315th freight train to Windrexville. There's an abandoned church on the top of Jay Mountain with a pump in the back, so don't worry about water. Get a supply of food as soon as you get there. This morning, before the story breaks. And once you do, don't stick your noses out until I come. Now get going!
Dallas, thanks.
Do you think that the cops... Get going!
There will now be a 10-minute intermission.
Beginning to get light. The old church is over there. Dallas was right. My dreams come true. We're finally in the country. You wait at the church. I'll go to the store for supplies. Be there first thing they open.
I wonder how the boys are doing back at home.
I can imagine.
I can imagine too. Later we found out.
Maybe Dallas knows something?
He didn't say.
Well, maybe he knows something. When the police worked him over, he told him he thought that they were headed for Texas.
Do you think maybe?
One thing's for sure, they ain't headed for Texas.
First time I've missed work since...
If you want to go on in.
Maybe this time he'll think to give us a phone call.
Well, if there's a phone handy and no one's around and they got some money and it's...
Okay!
No news. You both been up all night.
How'd you make out at home?
Not good. The worst.
That bad?
I said the worst.
Look, we have to talk.
Kira, you're making me nervous.
I can't live at home anymore. I have to get out. Right now.
Always stay here, Sandy. How can you get out right now?
How can I stay? I've been up all night, too.
You should have called.
So did Pop. I'm going to Tallahassee, Florida. My grandmother lives there, and I'm gonna live with her.
Hold on, you heard Derry. You can stay here. You don't have to move.
I can't stay here.
We were gonna get married.
We're 16.
Wait, in a couple weeks, I'll be 17.
Yeah, big difference.
No, Sandy, I'll be...
No, I have to get out. And I can't talk about it anymore, and I can't see you anymore.
What?
It's what I came to tell you. It's hard enough, Soda Pop.
But
don't make it worse. Don't do that.
Okay. Okay, for now. It's been a rough night. You gotta back off, but we'll write. We'll keep in touch and work things out.
You see Ponyboy and Johnny. Explain to him. I sure love you.
Sandy!
Looks like another fight. Over at the lot.
Goodbye.
I'll write and you write back.
Some socials after Tubit. Ah, never mind. Dallas is there.
They sure got a great diamond.
Hey, what about Sandy?
She's going to Florida with her grandmother.
You okay?
Why not?
Second time I've been jumped this morning.
The socials are a little, tense this morning.
Tense?
Hey, I heard you told the Fuzz Pony and Johnny you're headed for Texas.
That would be one possibility.
Could you think of another possibility?
You'd have to ask them.
Oh, man. Mustangs are tough. Oh.
Man, look at that redhead. Wait, that's a dead guy's girlfriend. Let's run her out of here.
Don't touch her, Dallas.
What's this? Going on the same as Johnny Cake now?
How is Johnny?
Well, we wouldn't know about that.
Oh, would you know about Ponyboy?
Ooh, the cops think he's heading, southwest somewhere.
Is it necessary to jerk me around like this? Well, we all know about Bob, don't we?
Yeah.
Yeah, too bad about that.
Oh, yeah, he's dead. Too bad.
Would you want to come in?
The reason I came here, this whole mess. Maybe it's my fault.
What about it?
So maybe I can help.
You?
Come on, Dallas.
How about I take you down to the dingo? I'll get you a Coke and we can talk about this and that.
Johnny and Pony need someone to testify for them and you want to make it out the dingo. I'm sorry, I've got to get out of here.
No, please wait.
For what?
It took a lot of courage for you to come here this morning.
Yes, it did.
Any message for the juvenile delinquents?
Tell them I say hi.
What?
Hey.
Dallas? What? I just want to talk with her.
Really?
Clear up this whole testify thing.
Yeah, right.
Don't worry.
You talk nice. You hear me?
I always talk nice.
Well, tell them I said hi.
I heard they went to Texas.
Your kid brother's so smart. Why can't he locate a telephone?
I've been in church before, but this falling down old place gave me a creepy feeling. What do you call it? Premonition? That's our signal. Attention to the storm. We're loaded up.
We got a week's supply of bologna, 2 loaves of bread,
a box of matches,
candy bars.
Candy bars.
Yeah, what else?
More candy.
candy bars, because we need those. What? Gone with the Wind. How'd you know I always wanted to read this book?
I remember you saying something about it once. I figured you could read it aloud to help kill time.
Thanks.
We're in big trouble.
I'm still tired. A little spooked, too. Things been happening so fast. Man, I'm tired.
Last night. Was it last night?
Last night we were walking Cherry and Marcia over to Two Bits. Last night we were laying in the lot, looking up at the stars.
Last night I killed that Bob. He couldn't have been over 17 or 18. And I killed him. I'm real tired too.
The next few days were the longest. We passed the time by playing poker, reading Gone with the Wind. Johnny was especially stuck on the Southern Gentleman.
I bet they were cool old guys, riding into sure death because they were gallant. They remind me of Dallas.
Dallas ain't got any more manners than I do. You saw how he treated the girls at the nightly double.
Yeah, but one time, I saw Dallas getting picked up by the fuzz, and he kept real cool. They were getting him for something Tubin did. Dally knew it, but he took the sentence without batting an eye, or even denying it. Now that's Gallen.
Oh, he's your hero now. Go back to sleep. Dawn the next morning. All the lower valley was covered with mist. The clouds changed from gray to pink. And the mist was touched with gold. There was a silent moment when everything held its breath. And then the sun rose.
God. The fashion is pretty.
Wouldn't it be cool to just be able to paint that sky?
It's too bad it can't stay like that.
Nothing gold can stay.
What?
A poem I read once. I was remembering it. Nature's first green is gold. Her hardest hue to hold. Her early leaves a flower. But only so an hour. It goes on.
Well, you go on.
So leaf subsides to leaf. So Eden sank to grief. Then dawn goes down to day. Nothing gold can stay.
Where'd you learn that?
Robert Frost wrote it. He meant more to it than I'm getting at, though.
How come you remember it?
I could never figure it out, you know? I never quite got what he meant by it.
I never noticed colors and clouds and stuff until you started pointing them out to me. It's almost like they were never there before.
I could never talk about that stuff with the other guys. I couldn't even remember the poem around them. They just don't dig. Just you. Well, soda pop sometimes. Maybe Cherry Valance.
I guess we're different.
Shoot, maybe they are. I was so tired of baloney. I got sick just thinking about it. We'd eaten all the candy bars and I was dying for a Coke. By that time, I read all the way up to Sherman's Siege of Atlanta.
And I owe Johnny $150 in poker games. I was beginning to think I always lived in a church. Or during the Civil War. Or both.
Need a magic trick.
Pony, hear it? Who do you think?
Lori, look at the church mice. Hey, Dallas. Little Johnny King and Pony Boy.
Never thought I'd be so glad to see Dallas Winston.
What's happening?
Is Soda Pop okay? Are the Fuzz after us? Is Derry all right? Do the boys know where we are?
I can't answer everything at once. You guys want to get something to eat? I skipped breakfast. I'm about starving.
He's starving?
If you'd like some bologna, we
don't. Thanks.
The Fuzz won't be looking for you around here. They think you, lit off in the other direction. I got Buck's T-Bird parked down the road. Ain't y'all been eating anything?
What gives you that idea?
You look terrible. The cops think you're in Texas.
Hey, why Texas?
Well, they know me, and I get hauled in for everything that happens on their turf. I might have let it drop that you guys were on your way to Texas. They beat it out of me.
Like I said, Gallant?
Y'all want something to eat or not?
Yeah, believe it.
Be good to get in the car again.
Dallas always did like to drive fast. As if he didn't care whether he was going to get where he was going or not. I mean, we came down the red dirt road so fast. Johnny and I get a little green. And then we stopped at a Dairy Queen. First thing I ordered was a Coke. Then we started gorging.
I'm going to start next on banana splits.
Guess it's time you told us what's going on.
Us and the Socias are having an all-out warfare all over the city. That kid you killed? He's got plenty of friends. I mean, it's so bad I started carrying a heater.
Dallas, you kill people with heaters.
You kill them with switchblades too, don't you, kid?
Please, Dallas.
Dallas, if you carry a gun, they don't worry. It ain't loaded. I'm not trying to get picked up for murder.
Sure does help with the bluff. All-out warfare. All over the city?
Just one more day. Us and the Socials are having it out. Once and for all, tomorrow night, the vacant lot.
Tomorrow night?
You guys will miss it. We found the president of their little social club and had a war council. So here's the deal. No weapons. If we run, things go on as usual. But if they run, they leave our territory, but for good. Outside. I don't care how many socials show up. They're gonna run.
Suppose they bring chains?
Hey, I didn't tell you guys. We got ourselves a spy. That good-looking broad I tried to pick up the night you, the redhead, Cherry, what's her name?
Cherry! The soaps?
The next time I want a broad, I'll pick up my own kind.
Yeah, we were getting the same advice from the Socias.
Cherry the Soch. Helping us.
Hey, she ain't Cherry the Soch. She's
anyway. She said if Johnny comes back, she'll testify that the Socias were drunk and looking for a fight. And you only fought back in self-defense. How about that?
That would really help.
Then I suggested we go for a ride in Buck's T-Bird.
Oh, how'd that go for you?
She said no thank you and very polite told me to go to... I mean, what did I do wrong?
Oh, maybe you should have tried a little conversation before making your move.
Conversation?
That might have worked. You ever tried it?
Man, this place is out of it. I mean, what do people do for fun in the country? Play checkers?
We're going to go back and turn ourselves in.
Whoa, what?
We're going back and turning ourselves in. I got a good chance of being let off easy. I don't have a record. Both Pony Boy and Cherry can testify with self-defense.
When they get their hands...
I can't stay in that church the rest of my life, Dallas.
When they take you in, you'll find... Grisha's getting worse than anybody. We won't tell anyone you helped us. We can give you what's left of the money.
Are you sure you want to go back?
It's not fair to Ponyboy having to stay in that church. With Derry and Soda worrying about him all the time.
Derry, Tony, yes he does!
I don't guess my parents have been worried about me.
The boys are worried. I mean, Tubit was going to Texas to find you guys.
My parents, did they ask about me?
No, they didn't.
Shoot, Johnny, what does it matter? I mean, my old man doesn't give a hang whether I'm dead in the gutter, drunk in a car wreck, or in jail. It doesn't bother me none.
Hey, let's go back to the church. Okay, I left a book there.
Get in the car. Sure would have been a lot easier if you guys would have turned yourselves in 5 days ago.
I was scared. I still am.
I'm not mad at you, Johnny. I don't want you to get hurt. I mean, you don't know what a couple months in jail can do to you.
Like it happened to you.
You get me.
We got to the top of the hill and Dallas slammed on the brakes. I mean, we couldn't believe what was happening.
Glory, the church is on fire.
Hey, let's go.
What for? Get back in the car.
People over there.
It's not our problem. If you don't get back in...
Hey, what's going on?
I don't know. We were having a school outing and suddenly the place was in flames. There were kids with matches.
Our matches?
No children! Stand back! Wait for the firemen.
Some of the kids are missing.
They'll be around somewhere.
They're missing. They were... They're in the church!
We'll get him! Don't worry!
No! Wait for the firemen!
There ain't time!
God help us.
From what I remember, we slammed a big rock through the window and pulled ourselves in. Hey, Johnny, hand me that kick!
Got another one!
Out the window, little guy!
Stay low.
Are you enjoying this, Johnny? Hey, there's another one! Through the smoke!
I got him!
Hey, go. Get out of there! Get out! The roof is gonna collapse! Forget them stupid kids!
That's the last one! Pony boy! Johnny!
I think he's coming around.
Thank you, Mrs. O'Brien.
Where are you taking me?
Fly back, kid. You're in an ambulance.
An ambulance? Where's Johnny? Where's Dallas?
They're in the ambulance right behind us.
Just calm down. You're going to be okay. You just passed out.
I didn't pass out. Dallas hit me. He knocked me out.
That's because your back was in flames.
I didn't even feel it.
That's because your friend put it out before you could get burnt.
Are you taking us to the police station?
The police station?
Why would we take you to the police station? We're taking all of you to the hospital.
Johnny and Dallas are all right.
Which one's which?
Johnny's the one with the long blonde hair. And Dallas is the mean-looking one.
Dallas will be all right. He burnt his arm trying to drag the other kid through the window. Johnny. I don't know about Johnny. A piece of timber caught him across the back. He might have a broken back.
He has severe burns. Severe. They're giving him plasma now.
You better lie back. It's better if you lie back. I swear you three are the bravest kids I've ever seen. Are you professional heroes or something?
I think you were sent straight from heaven.
Are the little kids okay?
They're okay, thank you. A lot of the parents want to thank you, too.
They checked me over, except for a couple of burns and a big bruise across my back. I was all right. Hey, Dallas, if you ever do a stupid thing like that again, I will beat the tar out of you. You hear me? If you ever. Johnny Cake.
Mrs. O'Brien is downstairs talking to some reporters. Some people phone the front desk. They're on their way up now. Claim to be your brothers or something.
My brothers?
That's what they said.
But how did they know?
Phone number in your wallet.
Pony! Soda Pop! Where you been? You trying to scare us to death? Pony Boy. Terry! Terry, listen, I'm sorry, okay? I meant to. I was gonna call her. Like Mom and Dad. It don't look like you got much sleep this week. Hardly slept at all. Neither did we. Doctor, we're taking our kid brother home.
He'll be fine. There's no paperwork. You can head along home.
I asked about Johnny and Dallas. They didn't tell us anything.
Are you members of the family?
I can only speak with the families.
Doctor, Johnny and Dallas, they don't have much family except us.
We're about as much family as they got.
All right. Dallas Winston should be fine after 2 or 3 days in the hospital. One arm is pretty bad, but we'll get back to the use of it.
Tell us about Johnny.
We already phoned his parents.
Tell it to us straight.
Johnny Cade is in critical condition. His back is broken. He's in severe shock and suffering from third-degree burns.
What are you doing for him?
Everything we can to ease the pain, but because his back is broken, he can't feel any of the burns below the waist. Even if he lives...
Yeah.
I thought I heard you say if.
If he lives, he'll be a cripple.
You see, conscience.
In and out.
He keeps calling for Dallas and Ponyboy.
Can we see him?
Not now. What you do now is you go home and you get some rest. You wanted it straight. You got it straight.
That's right, Doctor.
You can phone in later and check with the nurse's station on this floor.
Pain was growing in my throat. Yeah, the doctor gave it to us straight, all right. I was starting to believe that, you know, maybe I was dreaming. You know, maybe I'll wake up and everything will go back to the way it used to be. Yeah, but it got harder and harder to keep lying to myself. The next morning, Tubit came over. Same as usual, only earlier. You can't believe a thing they put in the papers anymore. Who'd believe two greasy-looking mugs could be heroes? How do you like being a hero, Big Shot? How do I like what? Like a big shot. Look. Juvenile delinquents turn heroes. I like that turn, but you know. I guess we turned all of a sudden. It says you and Johnny risked your lives. One of the parents said the little kids would have burned to death had it been for you two. It talks about the fight, too. You got up here in juvenile court for running away and... Johnny? For manslaughter. If he survives. Why do they keep saying if? It goes on about how Derry and Soda have been working so you can all stay together. And how you've been on the honor roll at school. If the reporter puts in, the three of you shouldn't be separated after working so hard to stay together.
Separated?
It won't happen. The juvenile court don't do things like that to heroes. I was thinking of looking in our Chinese cake.
You want to come with me? It's pretty early. You know, I don't know about visiting hours.
I can't wait for visiting hours.
Pony.
Look who's here.
Hello, Tubit.
I know. You want a lift home in my car?
No, thanks. I'm with someone.
What?
He wants to talk to Pony.
Who is it?
Randy Anderson.
Yeah, why would I want to talk to Randy, okay? He's a sos. It's their fault Bob's dead. It's their fault Johnny's in the hospital. It's their fault me and Soda might get put into a boys' home.
I know that. Randy knows that. Look, it's up to you, but I gotta go.
Hey, can I give you a lift?
Maybe sometime.
Can we talk? Hey, you know the rules. No jazz before the rumble.
I know the rules.
Ponyboy, meet me at my car pretty quick. We gotta go see Johnny. I read about you in the paper. How come you did that?
Maybe I felt like playing hero.
I wouldn't have done it. I don't let those kids burn to death.
You might not have. You might have done the same thing.
I just can't believe a greaser could pull something like that.
Greaser didn't have anything to do with it. Okay, Tobit wouldn't have done it. It's the individual.
Maybe you're right. I'm not showing up to the rumble tonight. I'm just so sick of all this fighting. And no matter what you think, Bob was a good guy. I mean, he had a problem, but he was a real person.
Yeah, how could I know that?
You couldn't, and now he's dead. His mother's having a total breakdown.
Who's to blame?
Look, all I know is they spoiled him. They gave in to him all the time. He wanted somebody to say no. They just never would. He just needed someone to set limits, lay the law down, give him something to stand on, you know? This one time, Bob came home drunk as a skunk. I mean, it's disgusting. He's falling all over himself.
Surprise.
He thought for sure they'd raise the roof. You know what they did? They took the blame. They said it was their fault, that they failed him. Maybe if his dad gave him the belt instead, he'd still be alive, right? You know, the only person that ever told Bob no was Cherry Valance. No wonder he was so crazy about her.
I have to go to the hospital.
That kid. Your buddy. He might die.
Yeah. He might.
And tonight, people get hurt in rumbles. Maybe even killed. It's not like it does anything. You know, even if you rip us, you'll still be at the bottom. And we'll still be the lucky ones with all the breaks. Greasers are still going to be greasers. And socias are still going to be socias. I gotta get out of this town, man.
And running away won't help.
I'm our chicken if I punk out at the rumble. And I'd hate myself if I didn't. So what can I do?
I'd help you if I could.
No, you wouldn't. I'm a soch. You get a little money, and the whole world hates you.
No, you hate the world. I have to go. You'd have saved those kids. Okay, same as we did.
Yeah, thanks, Grease. Look. I didn't mean that. I meant, thank you, kid.
My name's Pony Boy. It was nice talking to you, Randy.
What did Mr. Super Soch have to say? He ain't a Soch. Okay, he's just a guy. He just wanted to talk.
You shouldn't even be up on this floor. Your friend is in critical condition. No visitors, absolutely.
It's our buddy in there. Lady, please. It might be good for him to see us.
Let them go in, nurse. He's been asking for you. It can't hurt now.
He's over here.
Can't hurt now. Hey, Johnny Cake. Johnny Cake?
Hey, y'all.
Hey, I got a riddle for you.
Oh, God, here we go.
What's the safest thing to be when you meet a gang of social outcasts in an alley?
Don't know.
A judo expert?
No, another social outcast.
You gotta find a different place for these things.
Don't get it?
They treating you okay? Listen, we're having the big rumble tonight. It's just too fast you and Dallas couldn't be in it. We're getting off our packs, getting off our territory for good. Hey, you got your name in the paper for being a hero. Yeah, you.
Tough.
I mean, I figured Southern Gentleman ain't got nothing on Johnny Cade.
The book. Can you get another one?
What book, Johnny? He wants a copy of Gone with the Wind, so I can finish reading it to him. I'll go down to the drugstore and get him one. It's just downstairs. Hey, don't you run away. Dallas is going to be all right. Me and Derry, we're okay now. Johnny.
It hurts sometimes. It usually don't. I can't feel anything below the middle of my back. I'm pretty bad off, ain't I, Pony?
You're gonna be okay. Okay, you have to be. We couldn't get along without you.
I won't be able to walk again.
You're gonna be okay, I'm telling you.
I'm so scared. I used to talk about killing myself. But I don't want to die. It ain't long enough, Pony Boy. 16 years ain't long enough. There's so much I ain't done yet. So much stuff I ain't seen. That time we were at the church was the first time I was away from our neighborhood.
You ain't gonna die, okay?
That's right, Johnny.
Dallas?
Still here, Johnny Cake. Hey, your picture's in the paper. Mine is too. A couple guys came by to rub it in about me missing the rumble tonight. But they were so shocked to see my picture in the paper without one dead or alive under it.
Good one, Dal.
We're gonna win that fight tonight, Johnny. We're gonna clean him out of our neighborhood for good.
Johnny, your mother's here to see you.
I don't want to see her.
She's your mother.
She's just here to tell me about all the trouble I'm causing her. Tell her to leave me alone. For what? For once in my life, just leave me alone.
I was afraid of something like this. I'm sorry, but you'll have to go.
Be back later, Johnny.
The book!
I'll give it to him. Now we need the doctor, please.
And we're gonna stop him.
They brought a book for you, Johnny. Gone with the Wind. We can read it together a little later, okay?
Can I have a piece of paper and pencil?
When I come back. I'm sorry, but you can't come in.
I'm supposed to see him.
He's my son.
Please, not now.
This is our thanks. After all the trouble we've gone through raising him, and he'd rather be with hoodlums.
The doctor will speak to you later.
I thought I'd find you here.
Hi, Cherry. It's nice to see you.
Oh, Ponyboy, stay a minute.
Sure. It's gonna be rough tonight.
Randy's not showing up for the Rumble.
I know.
He's not scared. You know, he's just sick of fighting. You know, Bob was his best friend. Just since grade school.
Yeah, Johnny ain't showing up to the fight either. Only I can't say he ain't scared. I mean, he's real scared.
How bad is Johnny?
Bad. Can't see him just yet, but... Will you please go up sometime?
No, I couldn't.
Why not?
Because he killed Bob. And I know that Bob asked for it. You know, he made it happen, but I couldn't look at the person who killed him.
You know, I don't get it. No, really, I don't.
You only knew his bad side. You know, when Bob was drunk, he was horrible. It was that part of him that beat up Johnny. I knew it was him when you told me that story. He was so proud of those rings. But when he wasn't busy destroying himself, Bob could be something special. He was something that marked him different.
Yeah, last time I saw Bob, he was drowning me.
Think hard, Pony Boy. When was the last time you saw Bob?
Last time I saw him, he was...
Don't go to the Rumble tonight.
They bring in blades?
No. They play your way. No weapons, fair fight, your rules. And Randy told me, and he knows for sure. I already told Derry.
Well, I guess we should be grateful, huh?
I'm not looking for gratitude. I only want to help. I like you, Pony Boy. I loved you from the start, the way you talk. Wouldn't you want to help me if you could?
Sure. If I could.
I have to testify at your hearing. Randy, too.
Yeah, to clear Bob's good name, right?
Will you all be there? You'll find out? You'd make a good friend. Pony Boy. Good friends are a little hard to come by these days.
I have to go.
Sure.
Hey, Cherry. Can you see the sunsets real good from your side of town?
Real good.
Yeah, well, you can see him real good from our side, too.
Thank you, Pony Boy. You did okay.
Wonder what happened to you. Do you feel okay? Because you look awful. I got a headache, okay? But don't tell Derry I'm taking a bunch of aspirins.
If you really are sick, and go ahead and
just fight. Shut up, and Derry won't know a thing.
I mean, you think you can get away with murder because you live with your big brother. But Derry is stricter with you than your folks.
Yeah, well, they raised two boys before me. Derry hasn't.
You don't look so great, kid. You're tensed up.
Everyone gets tensed up before a big rumble.
Skin never hurt anyone. No weapons, no danger.
You got a fever?
I'll be okay. I'll get a hold of a little one.
All right, you get in a jam, holler.
Promise. It's gonna be that time. Everyone happy?
I'm a greaser, a J.D. Nohood, and I blacken the name of our fair city.
Get thee hence, white trash. I am a Soch. I am the privileged and the well-dressed. I throw beer blasts, drive fancy cars, and break windows at fancy parties.
Yeah, what do you do for fun?
We jump greasers! Where's Tim and the others?
They'll be here. They're coming.
It's not all that's coming.
Let's get the rules straight. Fists only. And the first ones to run, lose.
You savvy real good.
I'll take on anyone.
Hello, Daryl.
Hello, Paul.
That's Paul Holden, the best back on Darius High School football team.
Well, that's Soch.
He used to buddy around, but he's got to be a junior in college by now.
Darius got to work.
I'll take you on.
You think you can handle me, Paul?
I can handle any greaser.
Made me think of a book by Jack London, where the wolf pack would wait for one of the two members to go down in a fight. But it's different here. The moment either one swings, the rumble is on.
Hey, hold on!
Wait for me!
Dallas?
Come on! Dallas! I thought you were in the hospital!
I was! I ain't now.
Do it!
Get over.
I wanted to ask Dallas how he got up, but a soldier was stronger than I took him for, was slugging the sense out of me. I thought he was gonna knock my teeth out. When Terry was through with him, Paul Holden was crawling out on his hands and his knees. Then he saw what was happening to me, and he took the Soch and he threw him back 3 feet. I figured I should help Dallas since he can only use one arm. I jumped on the back of the Soch he was fighting, but he threw me over his shoulder. Someone kicked me in the ribs, and you better believe it hurt. Dallas got a hold of him, but I got kicked in the head and I was stunned. I was lying there stunned, and then all of a sudden, Greaser started shouting.
We got him!
Yeah!
Oh, we got him!
Come on!
Get him off our turf!
Get out of here!
You're mad just because they got money!
Chase him home!
Yeah,
chase him the basketball! All right.
You alright, kid?
And I'll let you know as soon as I count the teeth in my mouth.
Look, we got some guys hurt. Better go check them out.
Come on, Pony Boy. We gotta go.
Where?
To see Johnny. We gotta tell Johnny.
Right now?
Right now. He was getting worse when I left him. He asked to see you. Come on, I got a car.
Got there, nothing flat.
Wait right there, boys. You can't see him. He's dying.
He's dying.
No, we gotta see him.
Dallas,
we're gonna see Johnny. If you give me any static, you'll end up on your own operating table.
You can't keep us from seeing him. Oh, okay, where's family? He asked for us.
Shall I call security?
You can see him. But it's because you're his friends. His family. Not because of the gun. Yes, call security. Go ahead.
Johnny. Johnny Cake.
Hey, y'all.
We won. Oh, we beat the socialists. They're out of our territory for good.
Fighting's no good.
Hey. They're still writing about you in the paper. All that hero stuff. I'm proud of you, buddy. I'm really proud of you.
Dallas is proud of me.
How are you?
Pony, wait. Stay home.
No, no, Johnny, please. Please don't die, Johnny. So this is what you get for helping people. You little punk, this is what you get. Don't be dead, Johnny. See, Pony? I was crazy for not wanting him to get me. If he got tough like me, he would have never been in this mess. If he got smart like me, he would have never ran back into that church. This is what you get for helping people. Wise up. You get like me, and you don't get hurt. You look out for yourself, and nothing can touch you. You hear me, Pony Boy? Nothing. Wise up. Hey, hey, get out of my way! Johnny's dead. We told him about beating the socialists. And then he died. Dallas told him we were proud of him, and then Johnny told me to stay home, and then we had a call. We know.
Dallas ran out. Oh, crazy. He couldn't take it. Even Dallas had a breaking point.
Yeah, yeah.
He kept telling me to wise up.
Pony. Dallas is dead, too.
We had a call from the police.
He pulled a gun on the security guards.
It wasn't loaded.
They didn't know that.
Dallas wanted to be dead. And Dallas always gets what he wants.
Hey, easy, little buddy. There's nothing you could have done.
Pony, what's wrong?
The world was spinning around me. Blobs of faces and visions. I felt so hot. And then Soda was standing there. Hey, Soda. Hey, is someone sick?
Yeah. Go back to sleep now.
And then I remember. I remembered that Johnny and Dallas were dead. But I didn't want to think about that. I didn't want to think about Johnny not wanting to die. About Dallas telling me to wise up and the waving the empty gun at the security guards.
Hey, Derry! Derry, what's wrong with me?
Fever, exhaustion, shock, a minor concussion.
Where'd I get the concussion?
From getting kicked in the head. You've been asleep and delirious ever since Saturday night.
Oh, God. I'll never catch up on the schoolwork that I missed. And I've gotta go to court. Are they gonna split us up? Put me in a home, Derry!
I don't know, babe. Hey. Johnny left you his copy of Gone with the Wind. He told the nurse he wanted you to have it.
I'd never finish it. I'd never get past the part where the southern gentlemen go riding into sure death because they're gallant.
Get some more rest.
The hearing was the day after. Jerry really surprised me.
Bob had been drunk. He had been drinking, and when he took me home, he said he was going to go back and fix Johnny and Pony for picking up his girl. And when I begged him, he told me to shut up and get out of the car. He was not himself. He was crazy. He was like that when he got drunk.
Sir, it was all our fault. They only started fighting back when it looked like Bob was about to kill Ponyboy. It was in self-defense. The judge talked to the doctor and it's one of my teachers. Called me, I was scared stiff. But he hardly asked me anything. Did I like living with my brothers? What about school and stuff like that? He even told me to quit chewing on my fingernails. Then he said acquitted, and the case was closed. I'd like to say that things went back to the way that they used to be then, but they didn't. Especially me. I started running into things. Like the door and forgetting. I'd be lucky if I got home from school with the right notebook or with both shoes on. I wasn't hungry. Everything tasted like bologna. And I was lousing up at school.
Ponyboy, I'd like to talk to you about your grades.
I used to make A's in English. Mostly because Mr. Stein has me do compositions. He's a real good guy, makes you think.
Your grades have really dropped. You're failing this class right now, but I'm taking into consideration the circumstances. If you come up with a good semester theme, I will pass you.
Yes, sir. I'll try. What's the theme supposed to be about?
Anything that you think is important. I want your own ideas, your experience, at least 5 pages.
Like my first trip to the zoo?
If you think it's important.
Yeah, I'll tell you what's not important.
Hey, what's not important?
Schoolwork! I mean, why all the sweat?
Hey, take it easy.
I'll just have to get a job and drop out anyway. So why not do it now?
You're not gonna drop out? With your brains, you could get a scholarship. I mean, we could put you through to college.
Yeah, big deal.
Hey, Johnny and Dallas, they were our buddies too. But you don't stop living because you lose somebody. You don't quit.
Look at Soda, okay? He dropped out and he's doing fine. So just lay off.
Anytime you don't like the way I'm running things, you can leave. Don't quite get you guys done!
What's with Soda Pop?
He lost Sandy too.
She's living with her grandmother. Okay, she'll be back. They're writing to each other.
This came in the mail today. It's the letter Soda wrote to Sandy. It's unopened and it's marked return to sender.
It's not even opened?
I'm sorry.
Hey, it's okay.
Listen, really? Pony Boy. I dropped out because I'm dumb. Look, I'm happy working in a gas station and with cars, but you wouldn't be happy doing that. And you have to understand about Derry too. He wants you to have the chance that he missed. We can't keep getting hacked off at each other anymore. We're all that we have left. And if we don't stick together, Pony, we don't have anything. Pony, if you're making it, you're making it for all three of us. What do you say, Pony?
You guys get out of here so I can concentrate. I've got a theme to write.
See you later.
You'll think of something. Something important. Johnny's handwriting. I asked the nurse to give you this book so you could finish it. Tell Dally to look at a sunset. He'll probably think you're crazy. But ask him for me. I don't mind dying now. It's worth it saving those kids. A few of their parents came by to thank me. And I know it's worth it. That guy who wrote the poem, Pony? You meant you're gold when you're a kid. Like green? Everything's new. Dawn. It's just when you get older, it becomes day. The way you are, Pony? Now that's gold. Maybe even gallon. There's still lots of good in the world. Tell Dallas. I don't think he knows. Your buddy. Johnny. Semester composition. Teacher, Mr. Zai. Pony Boy Curtis. Place to begin. I had gone to a movie. As I stepped into
the bright sunlight from the darkness of that movie house. I had only two things on my mind. Paul Newman. And a ride home.
I do not trust.